Hi folks, hope you're doing okay today. Thought I'd give you another instalment of my progress on the Chaminade. There are 2 weeks to go until the performance. So yeah, nerves are kicking in a little bit now, which is good because it'll get them out the way, hopefully, before the day. And I've just really been focusing on what I want to achieve with the performance, what I want to put into it and what I want to come across to the audience. And that's really got me thinking about the background of the piece and of course Cécile Chaminade herself, and what this, how this relates to me really. So if you don't know anything about her, she was born in 1857 in Paris, to an upper class family, so she would have been surrounded by music, and her talent was recognised at a very young age by many people at the time, Bizet, Liszt, other composers as well. However, her father really felt that it wasn't the done thing for a lady at the time to take formal study. She'd been advised to go to the Paris Conservatoire, but this wasn't something that he was going to let her do. He did, however, let her have private lessons in the piano, but she never obtained a music degree. And this really fascinates me because she then went on to say later that she really felt that this hindered her career, or it certainly hindered her to start with. And I can really, really relate to this. I studied music at a university, and at the time I wanted to be a singer. I didn't want to be a flute player, but I've always had this feeling that not studying at a conservatoire has really set me back as a musician who's trying to go out in the world and do stuff and work. It's one of these ridiculous notions that I feel is really still prevalent in our society, that it's just wrong. It's just wrong. So when I heard that, I just felt like I could really, really relate to that. The ironic thing about the concertino, the piece that I'm going to be playing, is that she was actually commissioned to write it in 1902 by the Paris Conservatoire, and it became their audition piece. So I just love that irony, and what was fantastic was, of course, her not attending herself didn't hold her back in the end. She did go on to have a fantastic career and write some amazing, amazing music. The other thing that I really admire about her, there are so many things that I admire about her, but the other thing was that she really stuck to her guns in terms of just making a career for herself and championing women. And she did that all the way through her life, and really championing women in any kind of creative sense. So she just stuck to it and kept going and had this inner confidence. And again, that's something that I'm slowly developing, in part thanks to all you who are watching and supporting me along the way. As I've said, I went to university as a singer, and then much later kind of switched back to playing the flute and really developing that, and that's become my home now. But I've always felt that because of that, it's taken me a long time to kind of catch up. So I'm gonna try and embody a little bit of Cécile's wisdom, in that just knowing yourself and knowing what you can do will and keeping going is part of the battle. And this performance for me just is gonna really try and, well, it is, it's gonna signify how far I've come, and I'm really hoping to go out there and finally feel like I'm worthy of being the flute player that I know I can be. So these two performances that I'm going to do are going to be very special to me personally, but I'm also hoping that people hear and enjoy Cécile's music and realise that there is some fantastic music out there written by female composers that deserves to be heard. So yeah, that's really been on my mind recently, and it's really affecting how I approach the piece as well, with lots of kind of confidence isn't the right word, but a kind of a strong voice and a strong sound that really represents what the piece means. So I hope you found this interesting. There's a really interesting video on YouTube about Cecile's life, which has been put together by a pianist named Anna, and it's absolutely fantastic. So if you're interested in learning more about her, then do check out that video. I'll put the link in the description. And yeah, I hope you've enjoyed learning a little bit more about the piece that I'm working on. As I say, there's 2 weeks to go. So I will be giving you another update next week, where I think I'll talk more about the final preparations and how I'm trying to deal with the overwhelm of the situation and the nerves as well. And yeah, hopefully all will go well. So thank you for watching. As always, I hope you found this interesting, and take care, and I hope to see you soon. Bye.